Hi, thanks for visiting our website here at the RV Corral. My name is Joe Murray and I'm the consignment manager here, and today I'd just like to take a second to highlight one of my newest consignments. Is a 1999 Dutch Star. The stock number you can refer to if you're interested in this unit is CA873. It's a 99 Dutch Star, model number 3862. It's a 38 foot coach with a single slide out, big large slide out. And this is a diesel coach. It's a 300 Cummins Allison transmission with 97,000 miles on it. This was, like I say, was a consigned, privately owned coach, and they've entrusted us to help them sell it. And just one of the many units that we sell on consignment here each month. This particular coach, I'm going to kind of walk around the outside and start, and then we'll go on the inside. But the owner of this coach, if you notice, it doesn't probably look like any of the other Dutch Stars that you have looked at. The owner painstakingly spent his time to make sure that this was custom, to fix things and do, well, first of all, notice that the stripes, they're not stickers, they're not decals. He had the full paint stripes done on this all the way around. It's beautiful, makes such a huge difference. That's the first thing to go on these motorhomes is the stripes. They start to peel and then it shows the age. This, in my opinion, looks like a coach 5, 6, 7, 8 years newer. He upgraded the headlights. We'll go around the back and show you he upgraded the taillights. We just got this in, so we haven't detailed it or anything yet. This is how it came into us. So we'll fine-tune this before we get to deliver it. So if you came today and bought it, we would do things like paint the steps. We go through, we wash the thing completely. So as we walk around this way, next thing I'll point out to you is the custom alloy wheels. And these were important to the owner, not only to replace what was on there before, just a steel wheel with a hubcap, but that they were a custom wheel and they had a neat different layout in the pattern of the cutouts on the alloy wheel itself. So all the way around, you've got wheels that you probably won't see on any other coach. Up top, if you take a look, you got encased awnings all the way around this thing. And as we go around the other side, you'll see what I'm talking about. But over the doorway, a large awning on the passenger side, on the doorway side. Awnings over the windows in the back. And then if you look just above that rear window awning, you see the top of the ladder. Well, you've got room to climb up there if you want, and you've got room for storage up there as well. So in addition to the storage that you're going to have on top when you climb up the ladder, this is a basement storage model. Okay, so these compartments here, I'll just show you a couple of them, are all storage, full storage. And let me open, I'll pass through here and open one more for you. Look at this. That storage passes all the way through to the other side. You got a good look at that? Again, this is how it came into us. We haven't shampooed a carpet or anything. We will get that done for you. More storage here, storage. Back here, we've got part of the electrical center. Back here, we've got your battery compartment, a little pull-out tray for your batteries. They pull right out so you can get to them. Bumper step, there's your ladder, the vent for your rear engine diesel. It's got a tow package on the back too, so if you want to pull a boat, jet ski, whatever you got to pull, you can pull it. Here's where you're going to have your generator. This is a 7.5 diesel Onan generator. Down in here, you've got storage for, looks like they got a water hose for your fresh water, and then a hookup for your electric if you want to, if you want to plug in when you're at a park. You've got a big generator. You probably wouldn't need that unless you're parked in a park. Back here's your dump station. It's got a little shower attachment. All your dump hoses and everything are all right here. And once again, that's how it came to us. We'll get this all cleaned up. This will look nice and pretty for you. And then your sewer hose is out here located on the outside. Some more storage compartments. Here's the slide out. Take a look on the back of this slide. Nice and clean. not scratched up. Look up over the top of the slide out. It's got an awning over the top of the slide as well, and the purpose of that is going to be to make sure that it keeps the water off of the top of that slide out. Anywhere you cut a hole in a motorhome or a trailer or camper, that's place where water can come in, and that slide awning that covers it does a great job preventing that leak or preventing any water from getting in there. So, and once again, it goes over the top here, it's encased, and then over the window in front of it, you've got another one, so that if you're parked in the desert and you don't want the sun beating in on your windows, although they're tinted, take a look, they're all tinted windows, the window awning will come down with a pull of that string right there, and now you've got shade. Take a close look at these stripes. See how nice they are? Those will never peel off. This is another great feature. I don't know that this is, oh, it is unlocked. A driver's side door. So you stop to get fuel and you don't want to pile out the other side, look at that. You can climb right in here. Two steps. There's your hydraulic jack module right there for control. You can take a little bit of a look at the cockpit. It's got flex steel leather seats on both sides. And those will pivot around, and you can use those as living chairs as well. We'll take a closer look at that when we get inside. Looks like there's a power window for this driver's window. There's your control for the mirror on this side. There's some more stuff. We'll look at that when we go in. Large side view mirrors. Folks, first thing, if you take a look towards the behind the driver's seat, you're going to notice the slide's open now. What a great amount of room it adds to the living area in a motorhome. This one only has the single slide out, but provides, I think, more than ample space up here. That sofa will fold out into additional sleeping area. And then flip back around here, take a look at the cockpit. You've got a TV up above here, higher up here. Here's your control center for all your power. You can check all your status on your tanks. Your battery disconnects right there. There's your slide out controller, LP switch, your TV antenna, your heat interface is there. There's a switch for your water heater. It's all in one nice location. And guess what? If you don't want to look at it, you don't have to look at it. We keep them open so it's easy to show. Very simple, clean dashboard design. All your gauges are real easy to see. It's got it looks like an updated Pioneer AM/FM CD player, push button transmission. There's looks like a CB on the other side, and if you look to the left of the steering wheel, that's a little bit different place for a backup camera. So you can see what's going on behind you without guessing. That's good when you're moving one of these bad boys. 38 foot long. So, come along the rack here. Again, I said all these windows are tinted, so we could see out, but they can't see in. There's a shade here that will pull all the way around to provide you privacy. It'll come from both sides and meet in the middle. So when you're at a park, now you've got your private area. There's a reading lamp, TV antenna, lights, and your ventilated air conditioner. We'll show you where that originates from in a minute. Lots of cabinet storage. Overhead storage here. They upgraded the chair here with a leather rocker and ottoman. Comfortable chair, very comfortable chair. If you take a look down at the bottom, you notice the other thing too is all the flooring in this has been redone. These, when they were made, I think came out with like a blue color plan, so he's redone this all with really nice like granite slate looking tile. The new sofa, like I said, sleeper behind you, four chairs and a dinette here. Dinette table is nice too, because you can move those chairs out and change that around if you want. Above head storage on this side. In the kitchen, look at all this room. You got a lot of room in the kitchen to move around. So someone can be cooking, and then someone can actually walk on by. Looks like you got an ice maker down here. Lots of storage up here. This storage will pass through to the other side. Big deep storage for your pots and pans. Looks like a coffee maker. Convection microwave oven. And a lot of the big coaches, you'll have a convection microwave instead of an oven. Big three burner stovetop. Lots of drawers. Some bigger drawers for your bigger stuff. Again, down here. And a little flip out here for your cleaning utensil or whatever you got to help you with a stove. Up here's a electric fan for ventilation, a big two-door refrigerator freezer unit. Like how the doors swing out so it's easy to access. There's a big closet right here, and it looks like it's plumbed. If you wanted to put a washer dryer combo in here, you could do that and still have lots of room for your pantry. You see that? You get a good look at that. Back here's your thermostat, looks like, so you can control your heat and your air conditioner in here. And it's all, look at these vents on the ceiling, it's all ventilated, ducted throughout the unit. So we swing back through this, I'm going to show you, first I'll show you the corner cabinet. They utilize every little bit of space in this unit. So in some coaches this might just be walked by an empty space. Well, guess what, there's a lot of stuff you can store in here and still walk through. As I'm going to leave this door open as I come through, and we'll turn back around, Curtis, and you can take a look. Up here is the solar battery charger monitor. Can you see that? So when you're parked, you don't have to worry too much about plugging in. You've got a solar panel that's always charging your battery full time. All right, I'm going to open this door. Come on this way. A large bathroom. It's got a big bathtub, which is nice. That's almost looks like a residential bathtub. Glass slider door. Looks like a sunroof up above it, or a skylight. I'm sorry, not a sunroof, a skylight. A solid surface countertop like you have in the kitchen with a nice fixtures. Storage up above here. Looks like his and hers, or hers and hers, if it's my house. Nice sized commode. Nice size to move around in. And then back here, you got a slider door here. Is it locked? Must be pinned up here. Slider door to come back and forth for privacy, and then come on in the bedroom. Again, upgraded design, newer carpet, storage on both sides, up above the bed on each side for clothing, drawers, nightstands on each side of the bed. And I think this has got the sleep number bed. I can see the controllers over there underneath. Let's see. Yeah, I bet you this one is one of those sleep number beds. Curtis, come on this way here and take a look up. You've got a entertainment system here. Looks like an AM/FM DVD player, Vizio flat panel LCD, good size. Ceiling fan up top, that's kind of nice, especially like I say, if you spend time in the desert. And these blinds are a day-night shade, so you want to get it nice and bright, just open those bad boys up. This is your fire exit right here. Again, you can see out, they can't see in. I like the way that this has all been updated. Newer colors. Come on back out here. We'll take a walk back this way so you can take a look from the back to the front. Just stand and take a look from right there. Again, lots of room. Very clean. Modern. I think this is a lot of coach to be had for the money, and well cared for. The consigner put a lot of time and energy and care into what he did with this. So once again, this is a 99 Dutch Star. Model is 3862 in the stock number. You're going to refer to is CA873. My name is Joe Murray, and my phone number is 541-912-8814. And I'm the consignment manager here. So if there's anything I can help you with, if you're trying to sell a coach, camper, you know, trailer, whatever, give me a call. See if I can help. If you're interested in this, just give me a call. 541-912-8814. Thanks for your time.